During a recent interview with Fox host Maria Bart Romo, former Republican lawmaker turned CEO of Trump Media and Technology, for some reason, Devin Nunes, he was asked straight up by Maria Bart Romo, when's the company going to become profitable? It's a very good question, right? I mean, it's a question that all of the people that are losing tons and tons of money on that stock would love to have answered. By the way, earlier this week, the stock dropped down to $36, which means it has now lost half of its value since it was launched just 2 short weeks ago. So things are looking very bad for Trump Media and Technology, and Devin Nunes didn't do potential or current investors any favors when he couldn't even give any kind of thing that resembled an answer when asked when the company would become profitable. Instead, here's how that exchange took place. Maria Bart Romo asked point blank, "I was looking at the filing to the Securities and Exchange Commission and the loss. When would you expect this company to turn profitable?" Again, totally fair question when you're talking to the CEO of a company. Devin Nunes responded with this very long, rambling answer where he said, quote, "Well, look, it's important to remember, Maria, that those numbers are based on what was the longest IPO in history, so we were overregulated. So if you actually look at the costs that we've built Truth Social, our beachhead against big tech and impenetrable beachhead that everybody said couldn't be done without using big tech companies, that was billed for a fraction of what many of these big tech dinosaur companies were built for. So even if you take the ridiculous cost that it took us to get to this point, we are well positioned. Why are we well positioned? Because we have no debt. We're coming out of this with no debt, a platform that works really, really well, that communities that communicates to millions of people, and then we have $200 million in the bank. As you move forward here, we're looking at the entire ecosystem. What does it take to make sure that we protect people in the United States and around the globe from these tyrants of big tech who want to silence them? So we're looking at the whole ecosystem, whether that's through acquiring technology, whether that's through building technology. Those are all the issues that we're focused on, and including, you know, making sure that we're dealing with like a 3-year plan here where we can go out and put this whole company together, where we're not relying on big tech. There's never been a company like this, and we're really the only game in town that can accomplish this." So when's it going to be profitable, Devin? I mean, that was the question. And instead you're like, well, I mean, you know, there's big tech out there and we don't like big tech and nobody's done what we've done, except big tech, of course. You know, they did it. They literally built it from scratch. Y'all actually just used a template that y'all found online. So you didn't build it from nothing. And you're like, we got $200 million in the bank. Cool. You lost $58 million last year. So that $200 million in the bank is only going to last you, what, 3.5 years, if my math is good? Yeah, that's not anything to brag about. What's your revenue model? Again, I cannot underscore this point enough. What's happening with Truth Social and the stock for Trump Media and Technology is literally exactly what I predicted would happen. I just did not predict it would happen this quickly. But now that that stock price is based on the performance of the platform itself, it's dying. And Trump can't sell for 6 months according to his contract. By the time he's able to sell, this thing is going to be completely worthless. I mean, that stock could literally be worth just pennies. People are already starting to short it because they see the writing on the wall. It's going to get worse. It is not going to get better. And when you have a CEO like Devin Nunes out there refusing to answer a question about when or if this company can ever even turn a profit, then yeah, it's safe to say if you bought this stock, probably a good idea to go ahead and think about selling. Well, folks, we have crossed that 1 million subscriber milestone, but rest assured, we are just getting started here at Ring of Fire. So if you're not already, please do subscribe to the channel and make sure to like, share, and comment on the videos.